That's amazing, Amanda, who you'll get to see later on because she was one of our mask winners. Let's get started because Amanda told me to. Okay, folks, so you know how it works. Grab a pen, grab a bit of paper, and pour yourself a drink. And get comfortable because it's Friday night, folks. And it's the Irish question mark and her indoors quarantine quiz. Do you see you got a promotion there? You're actually part of the introduction now. Alrighty, so you know where to find me. You can find me on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and Twitch.
Hey,
yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, my two favorite girls in the world, even ahead of her indoors. Thank you, Sophie, and thank you, Senna, for telling me to get going. So, folks, here we go with round one. Your first question tonight. HDMI cables are commonly used to connect TVs to other equipment. What does HDMI stand for? Ladies and gentlemen, Mom has arrived. Our Maid of Meriden. I'm here. I had a stressful day at work. I'm just about to eat and no drink. Alrighty. Well, there's not really much I can do about this now unless you had told me earlier on I could have got something delivered to you. I'm sure your liver and kidney will be delighted. Thank you, Robert, for your donation. Number two, in the TV program The Simpsons, Ardo, you should get this right. How many sisters does Marge have? In the TV's Simpsons, how many sisters does Marge have? Come back, Jodie's dad. All is forgiven. I don't care if you're out there trying to save the UK. The fridge is empty. Mom is starving. Number three. I would like you to replace these initials with words to make a true statement. I'm trying to do sign language to her indoors. The only sign language I'm getting back from her is this. So, yeah, I'm wasting my time, honestly. Oh, I'm also getting that one. Thanks for that. It's a family show, by the way. And you've just got me to do two rude gestures to all my friends out there on the interweb. Question number four, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Which country is the largest producer of tea? That is annually, not like in the next 5 minutes. Annually, which country is the largest producer of tea? Jesse, thank you very much for your very kind donation, my friend. Yes, if you go up the scroll, folks, there is a link because the QR code isn't working on the main screen, but it is working during the slideshow. So you'll get a chance if you need to scan the QR code for the virtual tip jar. Number five is Jan the Man. Nice easy one tonight, folks. Which Spanish football club plays its home matches at Camp Mine Camp? Her indoors goes Mine Camp. Camp Nou. I nearly said where it was. Which Spanish football club plays its home matches at Camp Nou? I thought I'd put this in so there would be a chance that our Finnish comedian, our FNC, Ardo, might get a football question right and feel more like one of us. Okay. Question number six. Is a cryptic music? Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji. Not only does Ardo know the answer to the football question that Jan the Man, our FIFA referee, asked, but he's actually been there. I am impressed, Ardo. Even the minions know the football question. My God, there's hope for Alfredo, too. So, this one here, Cryptic Music. Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji. Minion Jesse saying that's a first for him to get a football question, right? Well, they're not all going to be that easy. I put one in to make Gordy and Sue's up in Aberdeen feel extra love tonight, ladies and gentlemen, but you'll see shortly. Holy Moses! Look how early she comes on. It's Liz the Living Legend. And it's anagram time, folks. Gay Kinky Hitler is an anagram of which pretty female movie star? Write the letters down. Gay, gay, kinky, kinky, Hitler. I nearly done a sign I shouldn't have. Write them letters down and mix them up, and that is your anagram for a pretty female movie star. 5 points tonight for the anagram questions. There we go. Question number 8. Originally, in what country would one compete in a wife carry case race? Originally, in what country would someone have competed in a wife carrying race? Yes, indeed. Some people are lucky when they enter sports like this, and some people are not so lucky. What can I tell you? Yeah, but everyone's a winner. So, name the country that the first wife carry race. Yes, love, that would be you, the little petite one. Okay, true or false? Approximately every 15 minutes, cockroaches fart. Is that true, or is that something that I just made up? By the way, folks, talking about cockroaches, have any of you ever seen Joe's Apartment? It was a movie made late 80s, I reckon, her indoors. What do you think? Late 80s?
Maybe.
Maybe. And it was made by MTV, I do believe. But if you want to get over your fear of cockroaches, ladies and gentlemen, that is the movie to watch. Joe's Apartment. FNC, have you ever watched Joe's Apartment? I think you'd enjoy it. Number 10. You got it, folks. It is Dingbat. Dingbat. It is Dingbat. 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 Dingbat time. Yeah, okay. Now, ignore what it says underneath this dingbat. Solve this dingbat to reveal a well-known term or phrase. Because it is, in fact, a dingbat of a movie. A dingbat of a movie. Mistyped that one, folks. That is my official...
That's a typo.
That's a typo, yeah. Yeah, that's an Irish question mark typo. Don't be... Irish typo. I'll Irish typo you. Ladies and gentlemen, ho, 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 and a very Merry Christmas. How many days to Christmas are indoors?
No.
Start counting. Our pub Santa is in the house, ladies and gentlemen. Ho, ho, ho. Where's the bell? Don't be... That's Jan the man. Where's the bell? Ding dong. Unbelievable, man. If Scroocho was here, he would have a sound effect. That's all I got to say. Talking about Christmas, ladies and gentlemen... I don't know whether you remember from last week, but the plan is, because it doesn't look like we will be getting anyone here to see each other in the live flesh, even if I was inside a fish bowl during the quiz show, that we're going to do the Christmas quiz live on air from Irish Question Marks Grotto, right here in our lounge. Her indoors isn't fully aware of this. But I have the intention of inviting, ho, 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 you got it, folks, our pub Santa to sit 2 meters behind me and get royally pissed online. Yes, indeed, folks. And also I'm thinking, what about the Tuesday before the Christmas quiz? We organize a little Zoom mince pie eating get together so we all can dress up in our Christmas jumpers. We can Zoom each other and we can We can just maybe even sing a song. You never know. Her indoors might be here. I don't know. She might have left me by then, but we're not sure. But this is what I'm planning, folks. I'm planning a little ho-ho-ho Zoom get-together the Tuesday before our Christmas show. Not sure about dates yet. Her indoors is already going on the calendar.
22nd.
What, the 22nd what?
December.
Oh, and then are we going to do the Christmas quiz on Christmas Day? Is that the plan?
You can do it whenever you like.
Dress her up, take her nowhere. What am I missing? Minion Jesse said, what? Wait, a pie eating contest? Yes, indeed. You can eat as many pies as you want, brother. Now you've got them. Calm down, Jesse. Alrighty, the quiz quintet. Hi, Deb. Who's Deb? Okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, what's the Friday before that?
The Friday before Christmas.
Yes.
It's the
18th. Okay, so as long as our Pub Santa is available, Friday, December the 18th will be our official Christmas quiz, ladies and gentlemen. Our official Christmas quiz. And the Tuesday before that, her indoors is?
The
15th. The 15th. And I will be begging, borrowing. It really, honestly, sometimes I think to myself, you know, maybe I should just hire some help. Yeah.
You
I pay you every day with love from the bottom of my heart. And I feed you like a queen. Anyway, folks, I'll get back on to it. So what do you think? Do you think that's a good idea? Christmas jumpers. Well, I'll borrow a Zoom room from a friend of mine. I think he's got room for 100 people to come in. If not, we'll organize something, or I'll put it on to Jesse, Minion Jesse, to organize it, because he's a bit of a, I was going to say a live wire, among other things. He's a bit of a computer-ishy thingy me Bobby, laddie me dad thingy organizer. So, Jesse's saying, no problem. Is it a quiz on Christmas? Uncle Tony, you've never had the pleasure of being at one of our Irish Question Mark quiz nights. The Christmas ones, they are, a bit of a giggle. I do usually do a little bit of a Christmas theme to the picture round, and I do a Christmas round, sort of trivia on things Christmassy. The virtual tip jar is open, folks. The QR code that you see on this page is active. I had some issues trying to get it on the main page. So if you'd like to donate to tonight's show and you're enjoying it so far, or you just want to donate for me to shut up and finish the show quicker than normal, then please scan the QR code and donate through your Dutch banks. The other one is for any international payments. And folks, thank you very much for all your kind donations so far. Okay, now, double points for the picture round. And the picture round tonight is a bit of a mix match. Number one, I'd like you to name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. Name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. Now, I will let you see all of these questions once again, so do not panic. Number two, after a recent Instagram, who is going to host Saturday Night Live? In fact, I think it is tomorrow night in America. Which artist is coming out of the diet world and going to host Saturday Night Live tomorrow night? Uncle Tony doesn't like Christmas. Normally I would say why, but because it's you, I don't think I'll bother. Number three, who is this? Number three, who is this? Number four, which company uses this logo? Your next one, number five. Jan the Man asks, who tackled Virgil van Dijk on Saturday and has probably ended his season? It's a football question. Herman Doors has just went to the water closet or the ladies' room and missed the football picture round question. So let's see if she's back in time for the rerun of it. Number six. Sad news. Current affairs. Which musician announced that he has an inoperable brain tumor in the last week? Yes, Gordy, I do agree. It was a rather tough tackle. So number six, which musician announced that he has an inoperable brain tumor in the last week? Number seven, name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. Yes, indeed, folks, Streamlabs are reminding me that the most sought after item on the interweb is going to be raffled. Our last tricolor collector's item mask. And one of our three-color Irish question mark handmade face masks. Yes, indeed, folks. Minion Jesse is typing George again like he forgot to. Number eight. Who is this in a scene from his latest political thriller called Roadkill? Venice Max has just typed George. And you're now in the draw. Minion Jesse has tried to type George twice, so his better half is entered as well. Her indoors, by the way, you missed the football question in the picture round.
Sorry, hold on.
Thanks for that. Number nine. Which company uses this logo? Obviously, when you see the two logos, I have removed something from them. Family Van Tricht, thank you for your kind donation. Yes, indeed, folks, the virtual tip jar is open and going as we speak. And our last one in our double points picture round tonight, name this TV series. Okie dokie, you know how it works, folks. Let's have another look at tonight's picture round. And remember, any guess is better than nothing at all. Okie dokie. Number one. Name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. Number two, after a recent Instagram announcement, who's going to host tomorrow night's Saturday Night Live in the USA, United States of America? It's just about as big a news as their election. Apparently so. Number three, who is this guy? Who is this guy? Jay Tarhamsol, thank you for your donation. Number four, name which company uses this logo. Name which company uses this logo. Remember, folks, it is double points in the picture round. I'm very surprised at the music that Tony Blackburn's playing tonight, I can tell you. Jan the Man asks, who tackled Virgil van Dijk on Saturday and has probably ended his season?
Woohoo! Oh, sorry.
Her indoors, woohoo! This is not going to make people feel welcome at our quiz. We are totally impartial. It, like Celtic Rangers, I am totally impartial. But only for a couple of hours on a Friday night. Did I mention, congratulations, for any Rangers fan out there? Yes, the best team won. What can I tell you? It's been a while since I've seen Queen Park Rangers playing so well. Number six. Which musician announced he has an inoperable brain tumor? Announced in the newspapers and the websites in the last couple of days. Inoperable. Hey, what can I tell you? Huh? This is what happens when you have a better half that can teach you how to speak properly. Very quiet in the chat. They're concentrating. Name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. Name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. Alrighty, number eight. I want you to name the actor there, the guy in the middle. Who is this in a scene from his latest political thriller called Roadkill? Alrighty. Number nine. What company uses this as its logo? There is a little bit extra on top, which is the name of the company, and it would be like an Irish logo question if I left that answer in, so I didn't. And the last one, number 10, name this TV series. That is your double points picture round, folks. And look what we have now, a couple of familiar faces on the Mugs Gallery. Who will be the next winner of our masks? That is the question. Let's say hello tonight to our limited edition mask winners. We have, of course, Liz the Legend, Ardo, our FNC, and Jan the Man. We have happy birthday, Frank, and his better half, Val. We have Jody Was 35. Ladies and gentlemen, Jody's been very, very busy. I do believe 5 or 6 museums in the last 4 or 5 days. I think she's packing them all in before the lockdown happens. And we have our first double winner, Jan the Man. Honest Pete in Dublin and Cypress Kev. And, of course, our one and only Naughty Norma. And joining the mask winners tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we have Amazing Amanda, we have Joyful Julius, and we have indeed Responsible Rachel, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our limited edition mask winners club. Jan the Man is saying it's been a while since he's won his last mask. He wants to win again. He wants to be the first triple champion. Alrighty. Round 3, question number 1. This is a new type of question I'm going to ask, ladies and gentlemen. It's family fortunes. What's family fortunes called in Dutch, Debbie? Alrighty. Jody has confirmed 6 museums in 5 days, making the most of our staycation, enjoying Den Haag as we can't go anywhere else. Pretty soon you won't even be able to go out the door. Oh, thanks for that, Liz. Family fortunes, ladies and gentlemen. Liz the Legend, what is Family Fortunes called in Dutch? I've heard of it, but I can't remember what it's called. 5 tegen 5. Thank you very much, Minion Jesse. I'm glad someone's listening. Anyway, keep your thoughts clean, folks, because it is a family show. I know what most of the guys are thinking, but that's not the answer I'm looking for. Name something you spread. 5 points for the top answer. 3 points for the second answer, and 1 point for the third. So, 5 points for the top answer, 3 points for the second most popular answer, and 1 point for the third most popular answer. Name something you spread. Our FNC saying this seems a bit weird. Based on what? It's based on a television program called Family Fortune, you fool. Question number two. Which of the tropics is in the northern hemisphere? Which of the tropics is in the northern hemisphere? No, but the top three answers. Yes, indeed. 100 people were asked. When asked the question, what would be your answer? And that's how they work the top three high-scoring answers out. And that's what I'm looking for. The top three most popular answers out of 100 people asked. I'm sure in Finland they have family fortunes. But I don't even want you to tell me what it is because I won't be able to freaking pronounce it. Question number three. Tropic Thunder is not what I'm looking for. Holy Moses! It is anagram time! Write down these letters, ladies and gentlemen. Mix them up and it'll give you the correct answer. Our anagrams tonight are worth 5 points. Even Tits Dream. Yes, indeed. You heard it correct, folks. Even Tits Dream is an anagram of what promotional 13-letter word? Even Tits Dream. Okay. Question number four. What is the normal body temperature in Fahrenheit if it is taken and it reads 37 degrees Celsius? Ardo's asking, so this is from an actual episode of Family Fortunes. Would you just let it go? Yes, it is. Or else I admit the answer's a lot more vicious and rude-ish. dude, chill. If I was any more chilled, I'd freaking freeze. Alrighty, so question number four. What is the normal body temperature in Fahrenheit if it is taken and reads 37 degrees Celsius? You're right, Electric Sheep Minion. I think this George the Elephant is rather chilling in the video. Unfortunately, her indoors set George the Elephant up behind me in the background, and it looks like he's been impaled on the top of that stick. You know, honestly, what can I tell you? Number five is indeed Jan the Man. A football question, 4 points. Name the four Scottish towns or cities that have more than one Scottish league side in that town or city. So basically, folks, if you sort of guess four towns or cities in Scotland, you should get three of the answers, really. The other one's a little bit tricky. But I put this in to see whether our Rangers supporting friend up in Aberdeen, how good his Scottish football knowledge actually is. So there you go. 4 points up for grabs, ladies and gentlemen. And before he types in the chat, it's my pleasure, Jesse. It's a 4 point football question. Venice Max is on the ball. On the ball. We're doing amateur soccer now. Well, I wouldn't go to say amateur soccer now, to be totally honest with you. Which football team do you support? Venice Max. Pub Santa's just woke up again. Take the canary to the vet. Her indoors. Take the canary to the vet. Does that ring anything with you?
No.
I think Pub Santa's just woke up. Take the canary to the vet. I think he's having a nightmare. Alrighty. So, name the four Scottish towns that have more than one Scottish league side. Number six is another cryptic music question. Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji. If you'd like a clue, Arto is a massive fan of this band. That's Arto, our FNC, who will be coming up live very shortly, giving us a few jokes when I call him after the break. Arto. He likes to go away and create some air frying magic during the break, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed. Nice to see some people blast from the past coming in tonight for our Friday night show. This is show number 30. And Pete in Dublin saying, why does George Michael spring to mind? Yes, because there's a splash in a toilet bowl. But that's not what I was thinking. Number seven. I like this question, which probably means apart from myself and Gordy and Suze, not a lot of you will. Which Scottish river supplies over 90% of all the water used in Scotch whisky production? Which Scottish river supplies over 90% of all water used in Scottish whisky production? Gordy is extremely upset with Venice Max's remark about amateur football because it is Scottish football. Being a Glasgow Celtic fan, did I mention that we're nearly doing 10 in a row for the Premiership? But I didn't want to mention actually in case I upset Gordy. I just ignored Venice Max because they didn't even say which team they support. Okay, I'd like to thank Shell, the beautiful Shell, for gracing us with your company tonight. It's made my Friday night oh so special. Oh, and by the way, thank you for your very kind donation. Number eight, replace these initials with words to make a true statement. Replace these initials with words to make a true statement. Pretty sharp there, Dublin Pete. Why does George Michael spring to mind? Fantastic, huh? Okay, number nine. What is both the name of a small South American island and a bitter orange liqueur? What is both the name of a small South American island and a bitter orange liqueur? And number 10. Yes, indeed, folks. It's Dingbat time. Dingbat. 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 Dingbat time. Solve this dingbat to reveal the title of a well-known movie. Solve this dingbat to reveal the title of a well-known movie. little bit of disco music on Radio 2, ladies and gentlemen, the Tony Blackburn Show. Alrighty, Liz. So, folks, that is our first half questions. If you haven't got a drink in front of you, pour yourself a drink right now. And if you're the Maid of Meriden, our official Friday night mum, stuck possibly in Meriden, her indoors. Did I tell you? Meriden is the actual centre of England.
No way.
Honestly, the absolute, they say it's the heart of England. So what do you think of that?
Good place to be stuck.
Good place to be stuck. Are you glad I shared that little bit of trivia with you tonight?
Yeah.
I'm sure everybody else is shocked to hear that. So, don't forget to type George in to enter tonight's draw. Alrighty, folks. Yes, indeed. The virtual tip jar is open. So if you would like to do a little donation, thank you very much indeed. All the donations so far for our virtual tip jar, gladly accepted. Thank you very much indeed. These two QR codes are active in the slide that you are looking at now. Mira Meriden has just decided to try and enter the draw once again. It doesn't matter how many times. If you type it 100 times, you only get entered once. And I'm glad that our Friday night mum is not... I get it, Venice Max. Freddie, our Friday night mum is not dying of thirst in Meriden. She is in fact drinking Vimto. Vimto. Her indoors is jealous. Ooh, Vimto. Saying rather strangely. Okay, yes, indeed. Where was I? Yes. For next week's show, ladies and gentlemen, it is going to be our Halloween show.
Oh, wow.
What is her indoors going to do?
I'm on the case.
Oh, no, I'm going to do an impersonation. Yeah, I'm going to do an impersonation. It's a little bit of an advertisement for the Halloween. Just bear with me. It could be my Dolly Parton Halloween outfit. Yes, indeed, folks. Got a couple of pumpkins ready to carve them up to get our house looking like a Halloween scary cave. Her indoors is going to be dressing up and, of course, going to be doing a little bit of makeup on me to make me look young and beautiful. What can I tell you? Now, Mira Meriden, can't you get Vimto in Holland? Never mind Vimto in Holland. What about these orange-flavored twirls that you've been teasing me with on Instagram? I want to know, has Wasp35 Jody received any orange-flavored twirls? If she has and I haven't received any, I am going to be bitterly disappointed. So, folks, send me any photographs of yourself in Halloween outfits. And, we'll be, her indoors will be looking through the pictures. We'll play some of the slides and I'll be voting who I thought was the best outfit. You can send in as many different pictures of yourself as long as you're in different outfits, obviously. Okay, and also, if you would like to share any other news with us, you can contact me directly at irishquestionmark@gmail.com. Okie dokie. Now, You know where to find me on Facebook, on YouTube, on Instagram, and of course here on Twitch TV. On the YouTube channel, we will be putting up tonight's show later on, and there is quite a few shows on there from a selection of shows from the last 30 that we have been doing since this official crazy lockdown began. Okay. Here are your answers to the first round. Remember, it is 1 point for each correct answer, unless I tell you differently. By the way, Liz says I'm stealing a pumpkin tomorrow. So she's obviously going to go past one of our neighbor's house, steal one, bring it in, give it to her kids and say, look, I spent hours doing this for you. Number one, HDMI cables. They are classed as high definition multimedia interface. Give yourself 1 point if you guessed that one correct. Other bits of news is, of course, our Christmas quiz coming up with our Pub Santa and our Zoom get together the Tuesday before the Christmas quiz. I'll be putting together a little poster and putting it up on Facebook to let you know all the details. So, the Simpsons, how many sisters does Marge have? The answer is two, Patty and Selma. Give yourself 2 points if you guessed that one correct. Number three, replace these initials with words to make a true statement. Did you get this one? The correct answer is number two equals the only even prime number. The only even prime number. Alfredo Rodriguez, thank you very much for your very kind donation, Alfredo. No sign of the mask yet, I presume, or else I would have received a photograph. I also sent out a second mask to Ardo, our FNC. Didn't get any news of that yet. Ladies and gentlemen, the freaking Dutch Post are now infiltrating and stealing Irish question marks, most sought after items on the interweb. I will arrange with you, Alfredo, to meet at social distancing somewhere in the, over the weekend if you are free, and I'll get you a mask. Don't be getting so upset now. You're upsetting me. Okay, fantastic. Which country is the largest producer of tea? It is China. Give yourself a point for that one. Number five, was the Yan the Man? First question, nice and easy. Which football club plays its home matches at Camp Nou? And Ardo, our FNC, even he went there. It is, of course, Barcelona. Barcelona for 1 point. Number six, cryptic music. The hit number one was Night Fever by the Bee Gees. Give yourself a point if you guessed the cryptic music answer. Number seven, it is indeed our anagram question. Gay Kinky Hitler is an anagram of which pretty female music star? Keira Knightley. Give yourself 5 points if you guessed that correct. Happy birthday, Frank. Alrighty. Number eight. In what country would one compete in a wife carry race? The answer, ladies and gentlemen, is Finland. Yes, indeed. This is a task, question and answer, things that Arto should know. I'd like to thank you all for officially complaining that there wasn't a second why, so you couldn't guess the anagram question right, but you wouldn't have got it freaking right anyway. Question number nine. Approximately every 15 minutes, cockroaches fart. That is, in fact, true. And from three different scenes from Joe's apartment, ladies and gentlemen. Liz the Legend, I like the way you're thinking. Everybody give themselves 5 bonus points because I forgot a why. Venice Max, it's a silent Y. I like the way you're thinking. Dingbat time, it is, of course, Spaceballs. Spaceballs. That is the name of the movie in this Dingbat. Do we get bonus points for actually getting Keira Knightley? Why? Because you were seeing two Ys when there wasn't two? Liz the Legend says no, but I say yes. Alrighty. Round two, the picture round, double points up for grabs in this round. So the first one, name the movie title from the sequence of emojis. The answer you were looking for 2 points, The Sixth Sense. Great movie. Sixth Sense. Nice movie to watch around Halloween time with your grandchildren and scare the living bejesus out of them. Number two. After a recent Instagram announcement, who's going to host Saturday Night Live tomorrow night? It is indeed Adele. Six degrees of sensation. No. There you go, Minion Jesse. I like the way you're thinking. Number three. Who is this? This is Jeffrey Epstein. The reason why I put this picture in is because I came across this picture and I thought, I bet you he won't be using this in his presidential campaign. Alrighty. Number four is Vauxhall, the car makers. That's the logo, and if you guess that one correct, it is 2 points.
That's where the Y came from.
There's no Y in Vauxhall. Her indoors, an absolute freaking comedian. Jan the Man asked who tackled Virgil van Dijk on Saturday and probably ended his season. It was Jordan Pickford. Jordan Pickford, ladies and gentlemen. Electric Sheep Minion is saying that it is Opal here. It is indeed. Her Indoors has given me the nod of approval. So if you guessed Opal or Vauxhall, you will get points. Give yourself 2 points because it is the double point picture round. Ardo is just trying to mix me up. How many points was number 10 in round one, by the way? 1 point. It was a dingbat question, and it was tonight 1 point because the anagram questions tonight are 5 points. So, 1 point for every answer unless I tell you differently. My pleasure. Which musician announced he has an inoperable brain tumor in the last week? It is, I think, the singer out of The Wanted, a guy called Tom Parker. So give yourself 2 points if you had Tom Parker. And before you ask, Jesse, you don't get any points for Peter Parker. Number seven, name the movie title from this sequence of emojis. 2 points for American Beauty. American Beauty. Jesse was thinking Colonel Parker. I didn't know Colonel Parker was a singer, a musician. Parker from Thunderbirds. Her Indoors showing her age, ladies and gentlemen. I didn't know what she's talking about. Number eight. Who is this in a scene from the latest political thriller Roadkill? It is Hugh Laurie, ladies and gentlemen. Electric Sheep Minion. Theatres have a lot of trouble staging big shows at the moment. Is that in Opera Bowl too? I'd say it might be.
Good one.
And number nine, which company uses this? I do believe they also use the same name here, but then again, Electric Sheep Minion might just make a name up, or Jesse. It is Saab. And number 10, name this TV series. It is Better Call Saul. Yes, indeed. Alrighty, folks, that is your double points picture round. Arto, our FNC, get yourself warmed up very, very soon. We'll be expecting a couple of jokes. Her and Doris is going to do her weekly elephant joke. Yeah. Oh, yes, you are. Round three. Potluck. Family fortunes. Now, let me explain this to Arda or FNC because it's a rather touchy point. Did you find out, her indoors, what family fortunes, what it's called in Finland? You only had like 3 hours to work it out.
It wouldn't give me anything.
It doesn't give you anything.
No.
What? Not at all. No answer for any question about Finland.
No.
Maybe. Finland does exist. I know a guy from Finland, our FNC, our Finnish comedian. Ardo knows the show. The question is just weird. Ardo, tell me, what is family fortune known as in Finland? In Holland, it's 5 take 5. I mean, that's a freaking weird name. 5 take 5. It sounds like some sort of a freaking weird porno movie. Name something you spread. 5 points for the top answer. 3 points for the second. And 1 point for the third. It is not your legs. But I like the way you're thinking, her indoors. The first top answer, ladies and gentlemen, is butter. Bar. Butter for 5 points. Arto, our Finnish comedian, has just told me that in Finland they don't have family fortunes, but he knows the USA one. That could be a new job for Arto. He could be the host on Family Fortune and tell the odd joke in between. Number two, we're going to give you 2 answers. Jam or marmalade gets you 3 points for the second most popular answer. In a survey, when I asked 100 people on the interweb, and they told me the answer. And number three, 4, 1 point, margarine. 5 points for butter. 3 points for jam or marmalade. And 1 point for margarine. Number two, which of the tropics is in the northern hemisphere? 1 point for the Tropic of Cancer. Minion Jesse said, is the 4th answer, I can't believe it's not butter. No, because it isn't actually called that anymore. They had to change their name. Liz the Legend is saying, Dutch people think margarine is butter. It could be confusing for some of them. Everything I do on a Friday night is confusing for our Dutch viewers. 1 point for the Tropic of Cancer, ladies and gentlemen. Moving swiftly along. Anagram time. Even Tits Dream is an anagram of what promotional 13-letter word? Yes, folks, you are seeing. Happy birthday, Frank's better half, Val. It is, in fact, advertisement. Give yourself 5 points, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, if you guessed that one correct. And it's nice to see Val joining us tonight, even though they are on their annual little get-together. Well, it is Frank's birthday. Number four. What is the normal body temperature in Fahrenheit if it is taken and it reads 37 degrees Celsius? The answer I was looking for is 98.6. To get 1 point, you have to have 98.6. Electric Sheep Minion, how far out can we be? Her indoors? If they say 98 point anything, I think that's pretty fair. It's a Friday. We're supposed to be having fun here. Yeah? Yeah. Even you are supposed to be having fun. All right. Oh, no. Liz says no. In fact, she says, no, 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 96.6, 98.6 is the only answer. Thank you very much. Electric Sheep Minion had 102, so he wasn't getting a freaking point anyway. Gordy and Suze, Gordy says, who the Fahrenheit got that? Gordy really needs the pubs to open in freaking Aberdeen. Number five was Jan the Man, our official FIFA referee. Now, folks, there is a possible 4 points up for grabs. I put this in to make Gordy have an even better week. After Rangers winning in the Old Firm game last weekend, I thought, how can I make him feel even more important? Yes, by slipping in a four-point football question. The four Scottish towns or cities that have more than one Scottish League side are Glasgow with Rangers and nearly 10 in a row, Glasgow Celtic. Edinburgh have Hearts and Hibs, so 1 point for Glasgow, 1 point for Edinburgh. 1 point for Dundee because they have Dundee and Dundee United. And Falkirk. Falkirk have East Stirlingshire. Gordy is saying Stirling. Stirling. Which two teams are in Stirling, Gordy? Are you trying to get yourself an extra point? Liz said, I grew up in America. That gets hammered into you pretty early. I had Falkirk and I changed it. Well, then you don't get the point. Just one more thing about question one. How many points available for that in total? Oh. Question number six. I've forgotten question number one. What was question number one, Herondores?
Which round?
Yeah. Herondores wants to know which round.
Which quiz?
Yeah, you're right. It is Ardo. Cryptic music, guess the hit number one song from this music emoji. Now, I have to be very honest and I was concerned when Pete in Dublin said, has this anything to do with George Michael? But I knew exactly what he meant. It hasn't anything to do with George Michael. It is one of Ardo's favourite bands of all time. It is indeed ABBA, ladies and gentlemen. So, Waterloo and ABBA. I thought the US did temperature in pizza a degrees. Alrighty. Okay, it's technical problem time. Liz is going, no. Ardo, you're on. Tell us a couple of jokes. Alrighty, let's see. Have we fixed it? Yes, indeed. Getting better. Okay. What do you mean you're welcome? You haven't moved from your chair. What have I missed? Venice Max, did you try to turn it off and on? Yes, I am basically a computer expert nowadays because that was the advice I was given and it seemed to have worked so far constantly. Who was East Stirling's famous manager? I would say he might have managed Manchester United, I do believe. What else am I missing?
A Pete joke.
Where's Pete? What's Pete saying? What do you call a cheap circumcision? A ripoff. Lovely. I hope there's no Jewish people in tonight that we might feel a bit upset. But the QR code is back at least. Good man. Jan the man. Ouch, ouch. Yes, indeed. Ouch for a bit of a rip-off. Okay. Where was I? Waterloo, Abba. The next one. Which Scottish river supplies over 90% of all the water used in Scotch whisky production? Yes, indeed, folks. The answer is the River Spey. The River Spey. Uh-oh. Gordy's coming in with a little bit of good, clean family humor. What's the difference between a wand and a truncheon? I shudder to think. It's like dreaded delay, waiting to hear his answer.
Get ready to delete it.
The answer for this one, replace the initials with words. Four aces in a pack of cards. Gordy, one is for cunning stunts, and the other one's for... Alrighty! One is for waving, the other for whacking. Alrighty! It's getting a little bit saucy tonight, ladies and gentlemen. It's a good job. It's a family show. Remember, there could be children watching. Yon the Man, Speyside Whiskey. How did you miss that one? Call yourself a whiskey expert. What can I tell you? Number 9. What is the name of a small South American island and a bitter orange liqueur? It is Curaçao for 1 point. Damar 1980, four apples in a pint of cider. Four apples, you must be drinking expensive cider. And number 10, it was, of course, ladies and gentlemen, the Dingman. I put it to the American people, it's Friday, and I want to invite you all to my beach house for an epic party. What could go wrong? Brilliant movie, Weekend at Bernie's. Give yourself a point for that one. Okay, folks, it is half time. What I'm going to do is I am going to just whack up a little photo collage. We're going to take a couple of minutes break. I'll leave you in the company of yourselves to tell a couple of jokes in the chat line, in the chat room. When I come back in about 5 minutes or so, I shall be introducing you to our FNC, our official Finnish comedian, Ardo, who'll be doing a few jokes for us before we crack on with the second half of our show. So, time to go to the toilet, time to pour yourself another drink, and time to push the boat out, Mum, and open a second can of Vinto. Alrighty. All right, Gordy, nice joke. Is Google male or female? Female, because it doesn't let you finish before making a suggestion. Boom shakala! Well done, Susie. Top quality joke. Vadim. Oh, someone left his mic on. Guess what? I left my mic on. Up in the corner, nice to see Dumbledore's army joining us. And they're in the picture on the screen. Alrighty, folks. Okay, so let's get Arto, our FNC, to take the floor and to give us a couple of jokes there. Please, Arto, high-quality Finnish humor, ladies and gentlemen, at the absolute finest. But I think he's going to be hard-pressed to beat Susie's superb joke tonight. A couple of other nice ones as well, indeed. Okay, Arto, our FNC, have you got a joke or two ready for us? The floor is yours, unless you are obviously making some garlic bread or deep-fried Mars bar in your air fryer. Kyla likes the shout-out, Dumbledore's Army. Beautiful for you to join us at long last. Minion Jesse says, Arto, our FNC, Finnish comedian and air fryer expert, is too busy cooking at the moment. I would say more than likely he's on his out in his garden having a little cigarette or talking to his neighbors or socializing, or maybe he's just standing in front of the mirror and practicing his joke. Yes, indeed. What can I tell you? Our new face mask, the most sought after item on the interweb. Ladies and gentlemen, for some of you who have joined us tonight, these are three-layer Irish question mark face masks I got made in Ireland. Washable, embroidered logo on them, and I got 10 of these made. This is the last one available for raffle, the tricolour one, and we have some of these still available to continue raffling on a Friday night. So we'll do two draws later on. So hang around and you might get the chance of winning another face mask. Jan the Man is going for his third face mask, ladies and gentlemen, because as we say in Ireland, Jan the Man is as lucky as a girl with no knickers on. Work that one out for yourself. So is Arto back in the room? He likes to make people wait. It's all part of his ploy, being a good comedian, to build the crowd up. Although I think he's quite possibly fallen asleep. Maybe even, I was thinking, should Suze, Gordy and Suze up in Aberdeen, should she give us another joke if she has another one in the pipeline? Don't let Gordy near the keyboard, whatever you do. A little bit of Sade playing in the background, folks, if you're listening to Radio 2. Alrighty, folks, I'm going to just continue on with the quiz because Arto has gone AWOL. But you know as well as I do, as soon as I start the quiz, normally he comes bursting back in, and then we've got to put the whole quiz on hold so he gets his couple of jokes in. Oh, hold on a minute. We've got a bit of competition from Dublin. Pete says, why isn't there a pregnant Barbie doll? Yes, indeed. Thanks very much for that, Pete. Isn't it past the Dutch watershed? It's never late enough past the Dutch watershed for your types of humor. All righty. Okay, so Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is the Mugs Gallery, part of a collection of people that were lucky enough to win some of the Irish question mark mugs. I've still got a few of them that I'm going to raffle off during our Christmas quiz, ladies and gentlemen. Ardo has joined us. What do you get if you cross a pie and a snake? I don't know, Ardo. What do you get if you cross a pie and a snake? A python. I see. Naughty Norma's put a joke in. What's the best thing about Switzerland? Go on yourself, Naughty Norma. I don't know, but the flag is a big plus. Boom! Naughty Norma had us all sweating, thinking, what saucy response is she going to come up with? Alrighty, our limited edition mask winners, folks, remember, you have to type George into the chat to be included in tonight's draw. I'd also like to do a special shout out to my cousin in Armagh, Christopher, who every time I put these shows on YouTube, he watches it the next day. And it's just to let him know that I'm thinking about him. He's in lockdown at the moment on his own in his house in Armagh. Yes, these are our latest limited edition mask winners. Just by chance, they all chose the tricolour mask. And this is the last one available tonight if you want to pick that one. Amazing Amanda. Lovely, I'm glad you received your mask. We have Joyful Julius and good old Responsible Rachel, another one of the Minion gang. Okay, so you know you got to type George in the draw to get yourself into the draw. Minion Jesse has already claimed the tricolour masks and dibs on the tricolour one. Okay, so this is our virtual tip jar, folks. If you're enjoying yourself tonight, thank you very much for joining us. I've just put the links into the chat. Thank you for your kind donations so far. This is the main way that I'm earning money at the moment with all the venues closed. So I really greatly appreciate all your kind donations. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas. Thank you very much to our Pub Santa for your very kind donation. And yes, indeed, folks, sitting behind me in about a month's time, we will have our Pub Santa socially distancing 2 meters away. We'll feed him full of food and we'll feed him full of booze. And you never know, he might even sing a song for us. Alrighty. Space Dracula, I'm glad you remembered to type in George. And it's lovely to see you. Liz the Legend, thank you for your kind donation. Now, folks, what can I tell you? If you fancy me to come and do a show for your company or some family and friends, just contact me via irishquestionmark@gmail.com and I can organize an online show for you, your family, your friends, your company, whatever you'd like to do. Don't forget, you can check on YouTube some previous shows. And like I suggested before, if you want to be really clever, and this goes right down for Dumbledore's Army, this is a good thing for you to do. Contact some friends and family. Pick one of the YouTube shows that you haven't done. Watch it. Remember the answers. And then challenge your family to a Euro an answer. A Euro an answer, and it could quite possibly pay for your evening's entertainment. Amanda, amazing Amanda, thank you very much for your very generous offer. Thank you very much indeed. Folks, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, just do a search for Irish Question Mark, and that's where you'll find me. Please send in your Halloween photographs. We will be giving away face masks or a couple of face masks for the most impressive pictures of you in Halloween.
Family Butt, thank you very much for your kind donation. Okay, round four. This is the second half of our show. It's a sports question in the game of basketball. What is the one-word term for carrying the ball without bouncing it? Her indoors went extremely fast to her whistle, thinking it was a Yan the Man question, but it wasn't. So calm down. So in the game of basketball, what is the one-word term for carrying the ball without bouncing it? Now, obviously, I don't want you to say cheating. That's not the word I'm looking for. I'd like to thank Gordy for his joke, because obviously it wouldn't be Susie. A woman drank a bottle of Bell's Scottish whiskey. When she woke up in the morning, her knickers were ringing. Alrighty, Venice Mac says the name of in the game of basketball for carrying the ball with a person is rugby. Alrighty. Okay, folks, Searching for Sugar Man is a documentary about the hunt for which elusive musician. If you like music, this is a fantastic documentary stroke movie to watch. The music in it is absolutely amazing. So if you have nothing to do one evening, or in fact, as you've got nothing to do most evenings except Fridays, check this out, Searching for Sugar Man. I'd also like to thank P. Van Venetian for your very kind donation. Thank you very much indeed for your support. Question number three. The Okapi is the only surviving relative of which large African animal? Her indoors, Okapi, is that the correct pronunciation? If you're Irish, yeah. Thanks for your help and support there. So, the okapi is the only surviving relative of which large African animal? Number four. It's anagram time, folks, indeed. A catch them woman guy is an anagram of which pretty American movie star? A catch-them-woman guy is an anagram of which pretty American movie star? And I'd like to give you a clue. It's got nothing to do with Keira Knightley. A catch-them-woman guy. And there is only one Y in the answer of this anagram question. So write down a catch-them-woman guy. Mix the letters up. And 5 points up for grabs for the anagram question tonight. I'd like to thank Adriana for your kind donation. Thank you very much indeed, and nice of you to join us. Number five, Yan the Man. Our virtual Dutch referee, FIFA referee, who was the first Argentinian player to participate in 4 consecutive World Cup tournaments? Who was the first Argentinian player to participate in 4 consecutive World Cup tournaments? It was about the basketball question, her indoors. Yeah. Try and keep up with it, will you?
I'm trying.
Yes, you are very trying. What can I tell you? Question number six. It's a cryptic music question. Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji question. Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji question, folks. And if you're wondering what music I'm bopping to at the moment, I am listening to the Radio 2, the Tony Blackburn show. Question number 7. This is a true or false question. The statement is, the word matrix is found in the Bible and means a womb. The word matrix is found in the Bible and means a womb. Is that true or is it false? Our next question, question number 8. Replace these initials with words to make a true statement. 12 equals A at the LS. Replace these initials to make with words to make a true statement. Number 9. Okay, I'm going to leave this on the screen for a little bit. 6 of these words have something in common. Which one does not belong in this list? 6 of these words have something in common. Which of the words that you see in front of you is not part of them 6 words? Drawer, knits, marker, spam, spins, timer, warts. So 6 of these words have something in common. 1 is the odd one out. Which one is the odd one out? So I would advise you to write down these 7 words. And while we continue the quiz, until I give you the answers out, you can try and work out which one is the odd one out. Drawer, knits, marker, spam, spins, timer, warts. You get that, Herndors?
Yeah.
I was nearly going to ask you which one, but I know you chatted out. Alrighty, number 10. It is a dingbat, folks. Solve this dingbat to reveal a well-known term or phrase, but it is in fact a well-known movie. Solve this dingbat to reveal a well-known movie. Get the answer to that one, Herndors?
Yeah.
I don't believe you. Write it down on the whiteboard. Let me see. Come on. Come on. Oh, she's having another look at it, folks. Write it down. Write it down. Okay. Yes, she got that one, folks. Lucky guess. She probably seen the answers and the questions beforehand. Okay, number 5, round 5 is tonight, round the world trivia, folks. So, question number 1. Which of the 7 wonders of the ancient world was located south of modern Baghdad? Which of the 7 wonders of the ancient world was located south of modern Baghdad? Question number 2. Time for the guess, ladies and gentlemen. It would help you if you had an Australian in your team. Which Australian state borders each of the other mainland states? Which of the Australian state borders each of the other mainland Australian states? Question number three. Which wireless technology takes its name from a 10th century Danish king? Which wireless technology takes its name from a 10th century Danish king? Right side of the world, Ardo should be getting this one, I think. What do you reckon, Herendors? Not a chance. I reckon he does. Good man, Ardo. I knew you're not that soft. Number four. Which country was previously known as East Pakistan? Which country was previously known as East Pakistan? So, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you are enjoying our little get-together. Unbelievably so. This is our 30th show, our 30th weekly Friday night show. Thank you very much for joining me, the hardcore bunch of lunatics. I greatly appreciate sharing my Fridays with you still. Number five, especially for Enzo Linguini, if he's out there, on which Italian island would you find the volcanic Mount Etna? On which Italian island would you find the volcanic Mount Etna? Your next question. Question number six. Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase! Hakuna Matata! It means no worries, and it was made famous in The Lion King. It is derived from which East African language? Hakuna Matata, made famous by The Lion King, is derived from which East African language? Is Minion Jesse saying Hakuna Matata is a popular phrase for cyclists? I don't think so. But then again, you never know. Well done, Herendors. Question number seven. I know. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, control your excitement. There are a possible 7 points up for grabs in this question, folks. Which seven countries share a land border with Hungary? Which seven countries share a land border with Hungary? So, seven answers required for this question. Which seven countries share a land border with Hungary? Question number eight. Replace these initials with words to make a true statement. 7 equals H of R. 7 equals H of R. Question number 9. The River Spree runs through which major European capital city? The River Spree runs through which major European capital city? Number 10. Which world-famous individual is historically protected by a group known as the Swiss Guard? Which world-famous individual is historically protected by a group known as the Swiss Guard? That is your round five all-around-the-world trivia tonight in quarantine quiz number 30. The Pope Santa said Sinterklaas, and Gordian Sue said the evil empire. Now I know who is on the keyboard. Round six, our last round tonight. Here's one of Ardo, our FNC's favorite type of questions. Family fortunes, five take five. Tell me a type of gun that doesn't shoot bullets. So, there is points for the top three answers from 100 people that were asked. A type of gun that doesn't shoot bullets. I'm glad you're so happy, Arto. 5 points for the top answer, 3 points for the second most popular answer, and 1 point for the third answer. Question number two. Question number two tonight is, what is the anthem of the European Union? What is the anthem of the European Union? Good old Ardo, our FNC. The one and only Finnish comedian. Okay, this is a true or false question, ladies and gentlemen. Members of the Walibri tribe in Central Australia, they greet each other by shaking penises. Is it true or is it false? Members of the Walibri tribe in Central Australia, they greet each other by shaking penises. If you think it's true, write down true. And if you think it's false and made up by Irish question mark, write down false. Number four. 4 points available. Put this in especially for Alfredo. Time to shine, my friend. What were the names of the four original members of Led Zeppelin? Even Uncle Tony could quite possibly get 4 points for this one. What were the names of the four original members of Led Zeppelin? Uncle Tony can't get it right. He was obviously popping too many pills and drinking too much wine when Zeppelin were out and about in his heyday. A wannabe hippie, Uncle Tony, a wannabe hippie. What do you reckon, Wasp 35? Question number five is Jan the Man, our official FIFA referee. Jan the Man asks, which country was the first to win two World Cups? Which country was the first to win two World Cups? I was surprised at this, actually, when I seen the answer. Well, surprised was the wrong word, I suppose. I thought it was someone else. Uncle Tony, how old do you think I am? Older than me, which is basically ancient. Joyful Julius, I want a clue. Clue. It wasn't Ireland. There's your clue. Question number six. Cryptic music again, folks. Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji. Guess the hit number one song from this music emoji. I'm glad that that my clue helped you, like it usually does. Yes, folks, I want to remind you about our Halloween show next week. Get your pictures in, please, as soon as you can. IrishQuestionMark@gmail.com. Her indoors and myself will have a little look at the pictures. You can send in as many pictures as you want of yourself in Halloween costumes. And we'll be having a look and giving away a little mask for the best Halloween pictures that we can receive. We've already got a few in, folks. Wonderful. I didn't have a clue who it was. Well, I knew I got the email, but when I went looking at the pictures, I thought, outstanding. And this person knows who I'm talking about, acting the clown. Okay, don't put your name in the chat because I might ask a question about it at the next quiz. Number 7, Game of Thrones. Minion Jesse, do all the pictures have to be different? Well, basically, if you're in different costumes, you have a better chance of winning the masks. What is the capital of Westeros in Game of Thrones? What is the capital of Westeros in Game of Thrones? So don't forget the Halloween pictures, email them to me, IrishQuestionMark@gmail.com. Pete5678 has just typed George and is entered into tonight's Irish Question Mark draw for the most sought after item on the interweb, ladies and gentlemen. Number 8, replace these initials with words to make a true statement. 7 equals C off the OR. Number 9. Captain Archibald Haddock is which fictional character's best friend? Captain Archibald Haddock is which fictional character's best friend? And number 10. 5 points off for grabs, ladies and gentlemen. It is anagram time. Marijuana, then offer a fee, is an anagram of which of our online quiz personality? 6 words in the answer, ladies and gentlemen. And anybody that gets this might get a bonus point or 2. Marijuana, then, offer a fee. Write down the letters you see, mix them up. There is 6 words in this answer. Marijuana, then, offer a fee. Write it down as you see it, mix the letters up. 6 word answer, folks. Five points if you guess it right, and we might give you a bonus point if you get it. If you get it, might even give you a bonus 5 points if you guess this one correct. We'll see how well you do. Okay. Alrighty, so I just put the virtual tip jar back into the chat because we don't have a QR code, and we'll flick through our pictures of our previous winners from the quizzes. Remember, this is quiz number 30 tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and up for offer is a couple of our Irish Question Mark collector items. Liz, we got it. Mic drop. I am impressed. Liz the Legend. You're not called Liz the Legend for nothing, I can tell you. Alrighty. Our limited edition Mask Winners Club. Who will be joining this picture of fair, friendly, and fantastic folk from all over the world, ladies and gentlemen? And there are our three latest members, all donning the tricolour mask. Amazing Amanda, Joyful Julius, and Responsible Rachel! Responsible Rachel! Alrighty, folks, to get into the draw tonight to possibly win one of the masks and to join that exclusive club, you just type in George, and you'll be into the draw. Alfredo will be in next week's show because I'm going to make sure in the next 2 days to get a mask to him, my friend. Okie dokie. Yes, this is our virtual tip jar links. The QR code for local Dutch banks is on the left-hand side, and any international payments is on the right-hand side. Thank you very much, folks, for your kind donations so far. If you enjoyed the quiz tonight and you want to throw a few euros, dollars, pounds, pennies, whatever you, whatever currency you work on, thank you very much once again for all your kind help and support. So, have you subscribed to our YouTube channel? You can see a selection of previous Friday night shows on the Irish Question Mark YouTube channel. All you got to do is search Irish Question Mark on YouTube and you should find my channel. Have you any ideas for the next show? It is going to be our Halloween special. Email me via irishquestionmark@gmail.com if you have any ideas. And also, if you have any pictures of you, your team, dressed up in Halloween pictures, folks, please go through your phones, your computers, send me as many photographs as you can. I'd like to have a look and give away some of the Irish Question Mark face masks for the best costume. Okay, wonderful. The beautiful Raluca, thank you very much for your very kind donation, my dear. Minion Jesse's saying he's going to dig through the archives. That is a scary thought, because God knows what he would go dressed as on a Halloween night. Her indoors, rather rude. She said maybe he could go as himself. There's just no need for that sort of behavior, her indoors. What about Shell? I wonder, I bet you she's done a few saucy freaking dress-ups. Never mind Halloween. Hey, baby. Round 4, questions and answers are as follows. This doesn't surprise me. 1 point for the correct answer in the game of basketball. What is the one-word term for carrying the ball without bouncing? It is called traveling. Give yourself a point if you guessed that one correct. Number 2. Searching for the Sugar Man is a documentary about the hunt for which elusive musician Sixto Rodriguez. Wonder who's your relation of Alfredo. This is a fantastic documentary. If you haven't seen this, Searching for Sugar Man, great show. Absolutely amazing music. Number 3. The okapi is the only surviving relative of which large African animal? It is the giraffe. Alfredo, you will love this documentary, my friend. Wonderful story, wonderful lyrics, and brilliant song. And a lovely, lovely guy. Anyway, as I was saying, question number 4 is an anagram. A catch them woman guy is an anagram of which pretty American movie star? With the correct number of Y's, it is Matthew McConaughey. 5 points if you guessed that correct. Next question, number five, was a Jan the Man question. Who was the first Argentinian player to participate in four consecutive World Cup tournaments? 1982, 1986, 1990, and 1994, Diego Maradona. Oh, Gordy, Gordy, Gordy. Number six, Cryptic Music. Guess the hit number one song for this music emoji. The answer I was looking for is You Can't Hurry Love. You Can't Hurry Love. The word matrix is found in the Bible and means a womb. It is true. Damar 1980, Unbreak My Heart. Great answer, but wrong. 1 point for each correct answer, unless I tell you differently. Number eight, replace these initials with words to make a true statement. 12 equals A at the LS, 12 apostles at the Last Supper. 1 point if you guessed that correct. Number nine, six of these words have something in common. Which one does not belong? The answer is marker, because all the others spell another word when you read it backwards. If you got that one right, well done. Her indoors is shaking her head. She's pretty impressed with that one. But she didn't. Did you get it right? No, she didn't. I'm not as surprised with that one.
I got a different answer.
You got a different answer. Okay, number 10. The movie was The Breakfast Club, folks. Tonight's a dingbat time question. Joyful Julius is joyful because he got it right and feels so proud.
So he
should, but I reckon another member of the Minion team actually told him the correct answer, and he's claiming it. Round five, your questions and answers. Number one, which of the seven wonders of the ancient world was located south of modern Baghdad? It is the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Give yourself a point for that. Number two, which Australian state borders each of the other mainland states? The correct answer is South Australia. I thought so, Jesse. And number three, which wireless technology takes its name from a 10th century Danish king? The Nordic Hitch and the Nordic B, Harald Bluetooth. Give yourself a point for that one. And it's a pretty interesting piece of trivia. Number four, which country was previously known as East Pakistan? The answer is Bangladesh. Give yourself a point for that one. Number five, on which Italian island would you find the volcanic Mount Etna? It is, of course, Sicily. Number six, Hakuna Matata. No worries, made famous on The Lion King. It is, of course, comes from Swahili. Number seven, 1 point for each correct answer in this one. Austria, Croatia, Romania, Serbia, Slovakia, Slovenia, and Ukraine. The the seven countries that share a land border with Hungary. Give yourself a 1 point for each correct answer or even each correct guess. Number 8, to replace these initials with words to make a true statement, 7 equals H of R. The answer is 7 hills of Rome. Number 9, the River Spree runs through Berlin. Give yourself a point for that one. And number 10, the world-famous individual historically protected by the Swiss Guard is the Pope. Round 6, a general knowledge round. Here are your questions and answers. Arto, especially for you, the family fortune question. Tell me a type of gun that doesn't shoot bullets. The top answer, 5 points, nail gun. Second top answer, stun gun for 3 points. And the third top answer, with a water gun or a water pistol for 1 point. You can tell that this wasn't asked in Ireland because the top answer would have been a spud gun. Or am I showing my age? Liz, possible 9 points, Liz. Possible 9 points for what?
The family fortunes question.
Oh, for guessing them all correct in the right order. Let's sheep in Japan, it would be a shogun. Oh, God, he doesn't get out often. A tattle gun, a tatty gun in Scotland. Yeah, indeed. Minion Jasper being charming. No. Liz, if you guessed them in the correct answer, in the correct order, and you guessed the three answers, I have to say, yes, you should get the points. Or you should get out more often and stop watching reruns of Family Fortune. Like Ardo's going to start doing, so he gets maximum points at the next quiz. Back to the answers tonight. What is the anthem of the European Union? Ode to Joy for 1 point. True or false, members of the Wallaby tribe in Central Australia greet each other by shaking penises. Well, as you can see, when men of the Wallaby tribe in Central Australia greet each other, they do indeed shake penises in state of hands.
COVID.
Never mind COVID. Well, you can't socially distance and shake a penis. Come on now. Well, the average man can't. Okay. Mark, I like the question, but purely executed. Can we not do this again? Yes, indeed. We might, in fact, do a R2RFNC Family Fortunes Round. I am concerned about the Venice Max's family greeting. Is it like twerking? Do they wash them first? Are you talking about the hands on the penises, Uncle Tony? I'm getting confused. 4 points available. The four original members of Led Zeppelin, John Bonham, Jimmy Page, John Paul Jones, and Mr. Robert Plant. Give yourself a point for each of the ones that you guessed correct. Or you knew because you're super clever, like Alfredo. Number 5 was our Jan the Man, our official FIFA referee question. Which country was the first to win 2 World Cups? I actually thought it was Uruguay until I seen the answer. 1934 and 1938, it was Italy. Number 6, the hit number 1 song from this music emoji, Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Me, Elton John and George Michael. Minion Rachel also thought it was Uruguay. See, great minds think alike. But fools seldom differ. Young the man wants to know, was Ode to Joy the answer to the anthem question or the penis handshaking greeting question? Ode to Joy. Oh, what can I tell you? Unbelievable. Another minion tactic, blame the others when wrong, indeed. What is the capital of Westeros in Game of Thrones? The correct answer for 1 point is King's Landing. Number eight, replace these initials with words to make a true statement. The correct answer, seven colors of the rainbow. George, seven colors of the rainbow. Number nine, Captain Archibald Haddock is the fictional character's best friend. It is, of course, Tintin. And number 10, 10 points available, ladies and gentlemen. Marijuana then offer a fee is an anagram of which of our online quiz personalities? Six words, Jan the Man or FIFA referee. One of my favorite anagrams in the last 30 shows, folks. Why, thank you very much, Jan the Man, for being just who you are. Alrighty. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed our little get-together tonight. It is time, I do believe, to stop the draw. Has everybody entered the draw? Please make sure that you have typed George and you are in the draw. If you've already typed George, there's no need to do it twice. Liz is on fire, 91 points tonight. Well done, Liz. Everybody is typing George because they all want to be in the draw again. Liz is typing John, thinking that it might get her like extra added. Magnificent 2. Well done. 76 points. Pretty good scores. Pretty good scores tonight, folks. What can I tell you? Mom is trying once again to enter the draw more times. Folks, if you want to, type in your scores in the chat and let's see how everyone done tonight. It was... I didn't think it was too hard tonight, folks. I thought I'd try and make it a bit more visual and a bit more enjoyable for the people that aren't... what do we type? What if we type, Mark, do bribes work? You know that you don't need a bribe where I'm concerned. Liz, worth a shot. Norma! Naughty Norma! Well done! A one-person sweetie team. Liz the legend, I love Mark. No, that does not get you a bribe to win the mask. Amanda, 37. Do not be concerned, Amanda, because in my eyes, you are amazing, Amanda. See what I've done there? Her indoors, see what I've done there? Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, amazing, Amanda. Ardo, our FNC, 53. I don't think Ardo can count. Alrighty. Okay, folks, what are we going to do? We're going to close the draw, and we're going to hope that it works. Divide Liz's score by 2 for accuracy. Gordy, keep your thoughts clean, my friend. Please behave yourself. Folks, has everyone entered the draw? I would ask you to please double check, enter the draw to make sure that you're in before I actually close. Minion Jesse, 195 for the minions. Yes, indeed. But that is counting yourselves all individually and adding up the total score. I am absolutely sure about that. Damar, 1980. Well done. You typed George and just got into the draw just in time. No, that's with the 100 points we got from her indoors. All righty. Conspiracy. Gordy dragged me down, Susie says. It wouldn't be the first time I'd say. Whoa. All righty, folks, indeed. These are our limited edition mask winners. Are you going to be part of this very exclusive club? We will be joined very, very shortly. Liz has said she has got 1,722 points so far since quarantine quizzing. I think Liz needs to get out more often, if the truth be known.
She can't.
Oh, actually, she can't get out. Yeah, you're right. Well, don't come out, Liz, because the window will be banged. Okay, folks, I am going to close the draw. So, last chance to enter tonight's draw, folks. Last chance to enter tonight's draw. Do not bang the table too much, because I'm thinking you could be stopping the computer during the draw. Alrighty. Entry is closed. It's looking good, folks. First winner is Grob88. You are our first winner tonight. Congratulations. Are you still online to claim your prize? Type a message in the chat if you are. Boom shakala, you are a winner. You can, would you like one of the three color Irish question mark face masks? Please let me know. Grab 88 said, finally winning. Her indoors is not getting a freaking mask, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to pick another one. Here we go. Next winner is Venice Max. I do believe they are joining us from the United States of America. Woo! Am I correct, Venice Max? Are you based in the United States of America? No, you're in the Liz team. Yes, I know who you are now, but that is wonderful that you have won a mask. No, Liz has already got her mask. The white horse guy. Yes, yes, I know. Okay, so there's a tricolor mask up for grabs, or the three-color mask. What I need you to do, both winners, Grab88 and Venice Max, is email me at irishquestionmark.com, irishquestionmark@gmail.com, should I say, and we will get them off to you, or arrange to get them to you, which is what I'm probably going to start doing, because I've lost a couple in the post, in the Dutch local post. I put them in a padded envelope, and I'm thinking that's the issue. They're thinking something wrapped in gold is in the freaking padded envelope. But then again, the Irish question mark masks are pretty priceless, especially if you don't have one. Liz said, I will volunteer to be the carrier. I bet you carrier will. The carrier of what, Herndors wants to know. Maybe you should go to the doctor. Venice Max, thank you very much for joining us tonight again. Maida Meriden, thank you very much for just being yourself. Get yourself organized, order in your shopping, because I think you're on lockdown at the moment in the center of England, and make sure you get a bottle of wine in. Grab 88 says, I'll try and pick it up. Socially distancing, of course. And Elkie and Alfredo, I'll be sending you a message after this quiz show to arrange where you and I can meet, so I can give you the mask. Folks, what can I tell you? It has been an absolute pleasure to share another Friday with you. Don't forget, our next quiz next week is going to have a little Halloween theme to it. If you have any ideas or anything you'd like to add to the next week's quiz, please email me at irishquestionmark@gmail.com. Thank you very much indeed. Nighty-night, Norma. Thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Thanks to her indoors for putting up with me. What can I tell you? Ladies and gentlemen, even though he is not here, I want you to think of poor happy birthday Frank. He is getting his annual happy birthday treat tonight with himself and his better half. I'd like to thank M. Claverstein for your kind donation tonight. The virtual tip jar will remain open while we play my favorite song that I like to hear every Friday. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, whatever you do, stay the Frank at home.
The whole world's caught a virus, you're not in this alone. But you can help to cure it, just stay the fuck at home.
We're all stuck here in quarantine, it's like the Twilight Zone. To save the world, you only have to stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
Don't you be a fucking dick.
Stay the fuck at home.
If you're locked down with your hubby or going in alone, sisters need to teach their men, stay the fuck at home.
Whether you've got 12 kids or you're living on your own, shut it down.
Netflix in your underwear.
Just stay the fuck at home.
But I need the gym and I need the beach. We hear you bitch and moan. You need to grow a brain cell and stay the fuck at home.
But I feel fine, I don't feel sick. I'll go out on my own. How thick are you, you selfish prick? Just stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
Sit on the couch and do fuck all.
Stay the fuck at home. If you think you're not at risk, you're living in a dome. Spreads faster than a hooker's leg, so stay the fuck at home.
To the doctors and the truckies, those who put food on our plate, you keep the whole place running so we can isolate.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
You can be a hero too.
Stay the fuck at home.
The only way to slow it down is isolate, not roam. Help the world get back on track and stay the fuck at home.
Sit on the couch and drink VV, get shit-faced on your own. We don't care what you're doing there, just stay the fuck at home.
If you need to contact family, use Facebook, Skype, or phone. Yeah, we've got the fucking internet, so stay the fuck at home.
From LA through to Berlin, from Wuhan through to Rome, there's people dying every day. Please stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
Don't you be a fucking dick.
Stay the fuck at home. Stay the fuck at home.
You be a fucking dick.
Stay the fuck at home.
Stay the fuck at home.
Alrighty, folks, thank you very much indeed. We'll see you all next week for our Halloween show, quiz number 31. Please send your pics to irishquestionmark@gmail.com. And if you have any ideas at all for some rounds or questions about Halloween, email them to me and I'll put them in the show. Folks, thank you very much. It's been an absolute pleasure sharing some smiles with you from my lounge to yours. Thank you on behalf of myself and her indoors. Have a wonderful weekend and please stay safe, folks. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.